Hey guys, and welcome back to Nikoville Place, or welcome to you too if you're new. I am here on the FTOG's Qantas server, and we are going to hopefully look at a few things today. We need to get the tree farm that I've been talking about up, and I think that's what we're gonna start with. So now, if I can get in first person mode and turn stuff back on, that would be great. So we need to fill up a shopping list here, because I'm going to use a Jansys automatic tree farm tutorial. And you can also check out his video for that. If I remember, I'll put a link in the description. But there is like a shopping list for this. I already have the pool and the two mana spreaders that we need, because I've changed out these for the Dreamwood spreaders. And, well, I changed out that one and that one. I didn't change this one because that is more than sufficient enough for giving this a little bit of mana whenever we're gonna make a rune or so. And those have sparks, so we shouldn't need mana spreaders on those. So, yeah. Okay. Now, we need floating hopper hawk, one run carpus, one munchdew, and an open crate. Let's see, do we have an open crate lying in here? No, we do not. Let's start with open crates. Actually, I do think we have planks. Any of these regular? Yes. I have so many different types of all these framed and something else framed. And yes, yay! We are working on the thing now. We got the open crate. Okay, so now we need to look up the hopperhawk, because I cannot remember how it's made. Hopperhawk. So that's two gray and two light gray, redstone root and rune of air. So do we have any rune of air left? We have one. We're gonna need more. Definitely gonna need more than that. So we need a carpet, a feather, and string. Actually, we just need one, don't we? Yeah, we just need one, so we actually have enough. So we need the flower petal bag. We need light gray. We need gray. And what else do we need? Do we need any other? No. Just need a little bit of grass? No? Okay. A little bit of grass. And it's one piece of redstone. Okay, so we use one of these for that. And then we take this one and toss it in the pool to get the pasture seed. And let's see, I guess that's it, just the rune left. Another thing I quickly want to make, and that is this little dude, living avatar. So is that planks? No, that's living wood. So I need five of those. Just a little sidetracking here. It's not gonna take too long, I hope. Come on, a diamond. So we need diamond. And I'm sorry if you could hear the squeaking outside. There is a truck or something driving past here with a faulty something. Probably brakes. Okay, so you need to turn this into mana thingy. And where is, oh no, it's already down there. Like that. And I also already have the Rod of the Lance, but I really want this one. So we need one bottle of water, one rune of water, and one living twig. Now, do we have a rune of water? Do. I'm gonna have to stock up some of these. I don't think we got any bottles, but that can be remedied very easily. I could have gone down to the witch farm too, actually, but that takes too long. Okay, do I have a pool? There we go. One bottle of water. And now I just need living wood for twigs. Or a twig. So now, if I understand correctly, if I put the living wood avatar next to the petal apothecary, and I give him this, do I need to... How do I give you this? I should be able to give you this. No? Okay. I thought I would be able to give you... Uh-oh. That's not what I thought I could give you. Waterfall. Okay, so how do I actually give you that? Let us take a look in the book. Okay, sidetrack turned out to be a little longer than I wanted. I'm sorry. To-do, functional, natural apparatus. Are you in here? Living with avatar. Doesn't do anything aside from looking reasonably pretty. However, giving it a rod can enable it to cast very magical. We'll give him that to cast it from Amon's brother, of course. Any that do, however, will have an explanation of what they can do when given to them. Okay. I'm pretty sure. See, can I not? Maybe I can't. I was sure I saw that somebody did that once. Or actually, no, that's not true either, because I was told that that would be a possibility. Rod of Disguise. Few examples of rods that will work are Rod of Disguise, Rod of the Health, and Rod of the Plentiful Mantle. Seriously? Those work, but not the water one? I think that's wrong. Can I toss it to you to give it to you? No? Okay, well, I'll take a look at that later. We have it, it's cute, and I can still fill this up manually with the Rod of Disease. That's good enough. So let's see, we need to get petals from... Flum? Get the petals from... yeah, tongue twister. So from the flowers and the redstone root and the rune of air, and of course I forgot the seed. That really annoyed me that I couldn't give the rod to the avatar. Maybe you can and I just don't understand how. Right, so that is a hopperhock. Now we need to turn the hopperhock into a floating hopperhock. And I think maybe that is just basically, I don't know if I need to, no, if I actually need to have another flower on there first, I think I do. Let's see. Let us see, can I see the floating apparatus? The icons are so small. There we go. Yeah, no. So I think you need... yeah, that doesn't tell us. But I do think you only need to grab a regular flower. So let's see, who do we have many of? We have 17 of this one. Oh, wait, we have 29 mystical light. Blue. If I am not mistaken, I think the dirt needs to go on the bottom, but we'll see. Am I just not doing anything right today? Do I need to turn it into glimmering first? Really? Oh, all these little details I never really paid attention to. No, seriously. Come on. Oh, you need two. Oh. Alright. Are we clear on what to do now? Sure. Now. Yay, we have a floating thingy. Now, can we combine this? Yes. Okay, so we got the floating half rock, finally. And then we need the agri carnation. We could do, and I'm probably gonna do that. Monopoles, two force relays. I do have the force relays already. We made those on the first Bhutan episode, I think. Borelands, warplands, slime ball, hovering hourglass. Just need one of each. Okay, so a borelands. Let's see. Four. That is lapis, monolens, and piston. Monolens is pretty easy. And piston is easy. Do I have... I do. And I got slime ball. Yay. What else do we need for the thing? Oh yeah, the piston, I need to make that first. Like so, we need that and this and this. Okay. Need planks. Wait, didn't I grab? Thought I grabbed this. Yeah, I need 3, 4. There we go, that's some monolens. And what do I need? Ugh, another redstone. I need more inventory space too. Okay, so that's a boar. Then we needed a warplens. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm turning my head every now and then to look at the list. And I have a feeling you can tell that. Let's see. Warp. Warp. There we go. Pixie dust and a monolens. Pixie dust was one of those. I think we might have that. Yes. Okay, so now I need another monolens. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like so. And then we need a hovering hourglass. Let's see here, there's so many things. Okay, so a small little interruption, because I completely forgot about the Ranocarpus and the Munchdew. I've made the Ranocarpus, but the Munchdew requires the Gluttony rune, which I'll show you in a moment. I just want to get this here done first. And let's see, something weird happened to my noise. Okay, there we go. First, I need to just milk this one. And then I need to put it back in the lasso. And I'll take this. Actually, no, I should have stayed just down there. Because we need to make ourselves a milk jar, which is made like this from cooking for blockheads. Now we take the jar, we put it at the bottom here. You don't need to set it up like I've done here, it's just that I like to set it up like this, just so the cow doesn't run away. And then you drop the cow down, and you take an anvil, and I'm not sure if this is gonna work because I've used anvil, but let's see. Yep, that worked. And you get the anvil back. Nice. So that's one thing that we need. And just need to get rid of all of this. Which is going pretty fast with this mattock. Come on. There we go. And we have a cow in a jar. Let's see here. Can I place you on the fridge? I can't. Will you count? Are you now a thing? I don't know. Maybe not. Let's see. Can I take this and place it over the fridge instead? Let's see. And the bakeware, and another jar. Is that now a thing? Milk, no? Maybe I need one of the other things. Okay, I'll look into that later. First, we need to take this and one of these. And we are just going to take the same material, because that just gets rid of that one block. And then we'll take this, and I think maybe we can have it up here. Yeah, up here sounds good. Let's get rid of that torch. Oops, I did more than that. And we do this. Like so, one more over, just so that we can get that around. Okay. And then we make... We're gonna need four because we're gonna need two for later. People probably are understanding right now what I'm doing. Let's see, I need to get up there. Okay, that worked. Hopefully it's not gonna start wandering around and I need to stop placing that on my hand. I'm trying to shift click it down to my bars. And we have a snowman. Which means we can now harvest snow whenever we want to. Hello, Mr. Snowman. Right, so that is what I wanted to show you. So I just made this kitchen counter, placed a cow on top, and now it's working. So now we can see here that since I have wheat and sugar in the fridge. Oh, that is pretty nice. If you see quickly, you can see all the stuff in the fridge when I open and close the door. Ah, cool. But yeah, now we can make cake. So there we go. One piece of cake. And then we can go to Britannia again and check the winter. Two snow, got it. One wool, got that. Cake. Root of water, which we're gonna need to make. So let's see, we need string, and we need sticks. Actually, let's do one of these, or two of those, like so. Let's make ourselves a fishing rod, like that. And let's see, water, reeds, bone meal, and one of those and one of those. Right, so by putting all of these things on here, that is now making us Ruin of Water. Let's put that there. I got the Wand of the Forest. So as you can see, this is filling up this pretty decently. There we go. Rune of Water. And then we need... Where is it? Rune of Winter, which requires Rune of Earth. We need to make that too. That requires... one piece of Mushroom. It requires Dirt, which I have. And... one piece of Stone and one block of Coal. Wait, it does not actually need dirt. Okay. My mistake. One piece of dirt. No, one piece of stone and one piece of coal. So, luckily I was out mining earlier because we needed coal and I was completely out of it. Let's see. I need 9 to turn that into a block. Like so. This, and this. And come on. Maybe I should switch it out. Hopefully the other one is a little bit faster. Right, so we now have a Rune of Earth. So, for the winter we now need both of those, snow, wool and cake. So, let's start off with the earth. Then water. Wool. Snow. And the last ingredient, which is cake. And then we need one of these to finish it off. I have so very little patience today. There we go, and we get the runes back as of the... I think 1/8 or something, which is pretty nice. Okay, so now these go in there. And let's see, Gluttony, Rune of Fire, Rune of Winter, 2 mana diamonds. So let's see, mana diamonds, this, and that gives us the Gluttony one, which takes even longer to make. But that is okay. Let's see, what else do we need? We need 2 lime, 2 red, 1 green. We have green? Yes. And we have red. So we just need 1 lime flower. There we go. Like so. Then we're going to need 1 seed as well. And this is done. And again we get the lovely runes back. I really like that. This is a second tier one, so I'm gonna put that there. Now unfortunately we will not keep the gluttony one. Oh, I looked this up. I think I just read that it was a suggestion. That might be where I got the information from. Because apparently that does not work. But you can use him as an elevator. Which is something I might do since I live way up here and I could put it way down there. Right, so now we have the Munchdew. And we are ready to go and put everything up. Alright, so I did a couple of changes to Jansi's setup, because I added coarse instead of regular dirt, because these doesn't change into grass. And I added storage drawers instead of chests. So this will contain the logs, this will contain apples and saplings, and the hopper will be up there. The open crates. Let's do the open crate. Let's remove this one. And then we can place the running carpus here. And then on this side. Let's see here. Can I? Yeah. Okay, so the first thing I also did was. Or warp, yeah? It says something else. Right, so you take the two lenses you got, you put the green one first and then the warp lens. So you take bore, warp, and then a slime somewhere. And yeah, so why do I only have one force relay? Okay, let's make another one. It's very simple. It is just you need to get over the fence and get down here without jumping too far. Come on. Let's see, we need one of these, one of that, and I don't understand what happened to the other one. Okay, let's see. Here we go. That was very easy, right? Now we just need to climb all the way on top. This is one of the reasons why I really want to move this, because I want this island to be a little bit more accessible. So now, I want to... where is it? There. Monopole on the ground. No, I don't want the monopole on the ground. Silly me, I want the spreader to be on the ground. Let's see, because the spreader needs to go through the monopole, or through the force relay and to the monopole. So we need to go up on here, place the force relay there, and then we need a way to get up there, so like this should do it. Like so, and then we click the right click the bore lens on that one. We grab our forest wand to this, and then we attach it to that. So now it goes upwards. And then we grab six scaffoldings, like so. Place that there. Go all the six up. And it is definitely gonna crash with this, so we will just have to deal with that. Yay, I got a stick. Aren't I the lucky one? Then you are supposed to skip one block, I believe. And then you are supposed to place another spreader. Like so. Can I reach you guys? Yeah, if I jump. It's nighttime. Let's sleep. Alright, so. Not sure if I'm gonna be able to get this right. I guess you don't right click that like that. How about like that? And then like that. And you click this. Oh, wait. Is that right? And then this. I'm not sure I'm doing this right. We'll see. Then you need the hopper. And the hopper goes there. You grab item frame. Can I get back? There we go. And I only have one sapling right now left over. So we're going to need to... Can I? There we go. It is in there. Cool. And then... So we're gonna have to sort this after a little while. Now, where is my Munchdu? My Munchdu is not here. Let me find my Munchdu, because I don't know where it is. So the running, not the running carpus, but Munchdu was left down in the chest for some reason. I also went ahead, since we only had the two saplings, I went ahead and I grew a couple over there. And we got some, one apple and such as well, so that we can sort this. And it also reminds me that I need another drawer just for branches and for sticks. So we need to set that up too, but not until we got this going, because that's just gonna be... I'm guessing we can put it underneath, so... No, actually we can't. Because, yeah, you'll see. But I also found out that, because I just looked at it and it looked weird. So, yeah, I moved these back, which means I had to move this back, so I now need to rebind. So let's see here. We have already bound that to the monopole, right? Yes. And then you right-click this, and you click that on that, and you take this, and you do that on that as well, because the original burst is going upwards, right? So when right-clicking it to this, the relay will pretend that it continues here, and it goes up to that. So when you bind this one to that, it's going to continue up this way. Because, as I said, the original burst is going upwards. And then this mana spreader, we can bind back to the mana pools. So now it goes in like a continuous loop. Like that, okay? Also, this needs to be bound to the mana pool. Right, that's good. And... Then we take, I could make this one floating, which I might do, but we don't have it floating right now. Oh, that is so annoying. There is, people are using a lot of base and stuff. So we're gonna have that right there, so that is gonna eat up all the leaves. Oh, wow. Yeah, dude, you're a little bit too, you're a little bit too powerful, little munchie there. But I was predicting that it would do kind of that, you know? But now it's filling up the mana pool, see? So that is kind of nice, because the only spreader it knows is this one. This one actually also goes up there, you know? Because it goes through air and everything goes looping. So now what we should do, or should be able to do, is... to drop a couple of these, and that should be then be planted. Come on. No? Oh, of course not. I'm not giving it enough time. Right, we need this. And you're supposed to use red sand, apparently, but I don't have red sand, so... Oops, nope. Hey, go away. Eh. Place this there. Place this here, since I don't have red sand, I'm using this. Did I set it to max? No. So now, if we were to drop a couple of saplings, will this work? Come on. Okay, so I finished the setup. I changed this into floating random carpus instead of the one that is directly on to the block, and that seemed to be the issue. So now it works. And I put red sand in here. I had to make a cataclysm real quickly down there and put it under the monopole and then toss a hardened clay in there to get the red sand. So now the timing is correct, and well, you still need to do the waiting for things to grow, except if you use bone meal, then you can see it. Like so. And the Munch 2 doesn't eat all the time, it has an internal cooldown, I suppose. But it is making enough mana for everything here to work. So now if it would just work on camera for me, I would be super happy. You can see the what are they called? Saplings being picked up and then dropped down again all the time just so they don't despawn, and yeah, it goes in a continuous loop with the hopper. There you see, everything is going like that. And now it's working perfectly. I also changed this out for this system here with drawers and trims and the drawer controller, because now I can have several of these just going around like this. So everything now goes in here. We almost have a stack of logs already. So I'm pretty happy with it, how this turned out. I did mess up several times and yeah, my memory isn't all that good, so... Oh, Jansi has had me watching his channel several times today. But yeah, I'll try and remember to put his link in the description so you can see how this really works on his under 3 minute tutorial on YouTube. Hope you enjoyed the episode, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye!